Suddenly, the animals in Prince William Sound were fighting for their lives.
There were otters that were completely coated with oil, surf scoters were sitting there, their throats had been ripped out by gulls that had, you know, seized opportunistically on these birds that could no longer fly.
Well, look at that. Something's been eaten. Look at that. It's got a hole in it. Eagles have been after it.
There were birds flapping in the water that couldn't get airborne because of the oiled feathers and such. It was truly a horrific scene.
Exxon took control of the cleanup. It hired workers to clean the shore. And marine biologists from around the country to save the animals.
The longer that a marine animal is sitting in oil, the more you're going to be dealing with death.
Terry Williams had just published a study on cleaning oil from California sea otters.
Everything we had learned was going to be tested.
It was a race against time. But the first otter did not arrive until day 7.
The otter was overheated. He was dehydrated, but he was in pretty good shape. I really thought that the job was going to be fairly easy. Clean him up, and he was going to do just fine.
Instead, the sea otter died.
You had cleaned him, we'd done everything we could, and you're going, why didn't it work?
With other deaths and autopsies, they began to find answers.
We noticed that the lungs were not normal.
He's lovely, this one, but he's been so sick.
The livers weren't normal. We were seeing ulcers in the stomach.
Otters that sick faced a slow death. In retrospect, Williams wishes she had put them down.
Knowing what I know now, there are animals that I would know enough to euthanize before I would put them through a whole rehab process.